हेलो। गाइस प्लीज टेल मी वेदर आई एम क्लियरली ऑडिबल नाउ और नॉट। आई थिंक आई हैव रेक्टिफाइड द एरर ऑन माई साइड। क्विकली टेल मी वेदर आई एम ऑडिबल और नॉट। ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन टुडेज सेशन वेयर इन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग द अप्रैल स्पॉटलाइट क्वेश्चंस। ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन। ओनली 10 स्टूडेंट्स आर वॉचिंग मी। आई एम सीइंग दैट आई थिंक द स्टूडेंट्स आर नॉट वेरी सीरियस अबाउट देयर एग्जामिनेशन बिकॉज द नंबर ऑफ व्यूअर्स आर डिक्लाइनिंग। सो गाइज आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू ओनली दैट यू नीड टू स्प्रेड दिस सेशन एज मच एज यू कैन सो दैट दी स्टूडेंट्स हु आर नॉट दैट मच सीरियस कैन ऑल्सो वॉच दी सेशन एंड prepare for their examination because this revision session is going to make you revise your current affairs. Okay, so let's begin. Okay, Sachin, current affairs is for 6 months, but if you have prepared 6 months thoroughly, then you can go beyond 6 months and cover 8 months current affairs as well. But 6 months should be your priority. Okay. Particularly priority is your GA. GA part is covered through these videos. For ESI and ARD, we provide you with separate playlist. Okay, for ESI, you have PIB 247, wherein not only your phase 2 of ESI is covered, but questions from phase 1 can also be, basically, in phase 1, questions from PIB 247 can also be asked in your examination. So, ESI, ke liye, I would recommend you to go for PIB 247, and particularly for ARD current affairs, we provide you current affairs in the form of videos which are provided by Pooja ma'am. So you can watch on our session the videos of ARD and ESI. Thank you so much, Sachin. Chaliye, let's begin with the session. But okay, Sachin ne to like bhi kar diya, subscribe bhi kar diya, but those who haven't done that, they can subscribe and hit the bell notification because this is going to help you in getting new updates about our channel. And this is the Telegram group which you can join if you want to enjoy the quizzes and get the latest updates. Okay, so let's begin with our first question of the day. Which state has received India's first advanced antiquities management system for storage of antiquities? Goa, Telangana, Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Gujarat are in the options. Which one is the right answer? Good. Goa is the right answer. Goa has got this system. Who is the chief of RBI's second regulatory authority, review authority, RRA 2.0? So this is very important, guys. You have MD Patra, MK Jain, NS Vishwanathan, BP Karanko, and M Rajeshwar Rao. Good. It's M Rajeshwar Rao who is the right answer. And let me tell you that the first regulatory review authority was set up in 1999. Guys, can you tell me what is the purpose of this regulatory authority, regulatory review authority? Why RBI constituted this authority? The reason in one line. Why was this created by RBI? Any committee that is created has a purpose. So, what is the purpose of this authority? What is the area of recommendation for this RRA? Quickly tell me if you know the answer. And even if you don't know the answer, you can just write it here so that I can tell you the answer. Okay, so I have got one answer from Gaurav. Review status of banks. Regulations. Okay. What about the other people? Okay, so let me tell you that this regulatory review authority was formed to recommend ways and methods to RBI so that it can reduce the regulatory and compliance burden of the regulated entities. So, compliance burden of regulated entities. All the entities that are regulated by RBI, be it small finance bank, be it banks, be it HFCs. So, whichever is the organization or the entity that is regulated by RBI, in order to reduce the regulatory and compliance burden of those entities, in order to streamline the process and reduce the compliance, I would say the steps in compliance, the layers that we have in compliance, the burden that the companies or the banks or any entity has to face, in order to reduce that compliance burden, this regulatory review authority has been formed. It recommends RBI how can the RBI reduce that burden of the entity so that they can function smoothly. So that is the purpose. Banks is one authority that is regulated by RBI, but RBI also regulate housing finance companies and other banks as well. Payments bank also, small finance bank also. Yes, chaliye. Where is the headquarters of Citibank located? Headquarters. Citi is an international bank. So where is the headquarters? US, UK, Germany, Singapore, and we have Australia in the options. Where is it? Good. New York, US. And who is the CEO of this bank? It is Jane Fraser. Who is the new administrator of NASA? So, what is the right answer? This we have discussed many times, guys. Who is the new administrator of NASA? Quickly tell me. Very good. Bill Nansal. Which mission is NASA sending to moon? Theek hai, which aims to land first women and second man on the moon's surface? Name the mission. Quickly tell me the mission. Which mission is this? Very good. Artemis is the name. What is the name of the new missions that NASA has announced to send to Venus? Artemis. God of Artemis is the mission that NASA aims to send to moon, wherein first women and second man will be sent to the lunar surface. The two missions that NASA has recently announced to launch to Venus surface to check the temperature and topography and everything about Venus. Come on, guys, this is a very recent question, and we have already discussed. Very good, Nirmal. Veritas is one mission. Good. Envision Ananya is by your European Space Agency. You can remember it through E. E say European Space Agency. V say you can remember Venus. So Envision here is for Venus mission by European Space Agency. Yes, Da Vinci Plus and Veritas. These are the two missions that NASA has announced to launch to Venus. Do remember these things, guys. Who has been selected for the 30th GD Birla Award for Scientific Research? So this is a very simple question of an award. Basically, who has been awarded this 30th edition of GD Birla Award for Scientific Research? Good. Suman Chakrabarty is the right answer. With which country has India signed an agreement for technical cooperation on cities combating plastic entering the marine environment project? Germany, Netherlands, Finland, Norway and France. So basically under this agreement, both the countries will cooperate technically on reducing the plastic waste that goes into the oceans or the marine ecosystem, rivers or anything related to the marine ecosystem. So plastic waste ko rokne ka kaam karega ye project, and for that project India has entered into a technical cooperation agreement with a country. So which country is this? Good, it is Germany. Germany is the right answer. With which country has India conducted the exercise Khanjar? Iraq, Kazakhstan, Israel, Kyrgyzstan, Uzbekistan. Khanjar is with which country? Yes, guys, it is with Kyrgyzstan. I know that the Khanjar word is very confusing because you can confuse it with Kazakhstan, but the right answer is not Kazakhstan, it's Kyrgyzstan. You can memorize it from its anomalous name also, that Khanjar is for Kyrgyzstan. Where was the Shantir Orgoshena 2021 exercise held? This means front runners of peace. So where was this exercise held? Ankit Sharma, this is a very good question, I would say. Dekho, whenever you are covering current affairs from one source, first of all, you need to understand this thing that current affairs is just like a vast sea of information wherein you cannot grasp all the information provided to you. Theek hai? So you need to, whenever you are selecting your source of information or source for covering your current affairs, you need to know that which source is competitive enough, which source will get you 50% or 60% marks in your competitive examination. Second thing is that you can pick two sources at max for covering current affairs. Okay, don't go for many sources. For example, if you are covering the current affairs for Spotlight from Spotlight magazine, then you can maximumly pick up one another source, but I don't think that is needed. If you want to just clear the examination with good marks, then Spotlight would be enough. Obviously, information would be provided to you from by the other channels, and that information might differ from the information that we are providing to you. So it is going to add up to your goals. It will be like 200% for you. Okay, 100% is provided by Spotlight magazine, and 100% per se if you are taking the course of EduTap or GradeUp or any PEET Wi-Fi study. So whichever the channel is it, whichever the mentor it is. Current affairs is like a vast ocean. Okay, you cannot just compile all the current affairs and put it in one magazine. So therefore, you are definitely going to have many questions and many other information from the different channels. Therefore, just restrict yourself to the competitive sources and maximum to the two sources. Don't go beyond the two sources. And two sources bhi tab lena hai jab aapne ek base source aapka bilkul acche se prepared hai. For example, if your base source is Spotlight, okay, and if you have prepared Spotlight thoroughly, only then you can go for other source, because Spotlight, I think, is enough for you to get 60% marks in your GA, and 60% can never be the cutoff in any competitive examination. Okay, so just keep this thing in your mind. So base source, if you have kept Spotlight as your base source, then cover it thoroughly and then you can go for other source. Okay. So that was my question for your, my answer for your question. Gaurav, PDF is Spotlight. All the questions have been picked up from Spotlight magazine. So you can download the Spotlight from our website. Link is provided to you in description. Okay, so coming back to the question, Bangladesh is the right answer. Achha, this exercise took place in Bangladesh. And India, Bangladesh both participated in this exercise to celebrate the 50th anniversary of father of Bangladesh, Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. So that is the full name of the father of Bangladesh. Where is Natanz nuclear power plant located? Sorry guys, it's the 100th anniversary of Mujibur Rahman. It's the 100th anniversary, okay? 50th is the Independence Day of Bangladesh. Bangladesh became an independent country in 1971, and this year it became, and it is the 50th anniversary, 50th Independence Day of Bangladesh. Very good guys, it is option A, Iran. Which has become the first helicopter in the world to fly on another world, basically to fly on the, in the atmosphere of Mars? So which one is the first helicopter? Ye to pata hi hoga, because it was such a great scoop when it came out that the first helicopter flew in another planet. So which helicopter is it? Good, it is Ingenuity. And what is the name of the rover that NASA has sent to Mars? Quickly tell me the name of the rover that NASA has sent to Mars. Ingenuity is the helicopter, guys. Very good, Nilesh. It is Perseverance. Perseverance is the name of the rover that was sent to Mars by NASA. Do remember these things, guys. What is India's rank on World Press Freedom Index 2021? So these are the options. Quickly tell me that what is India's rank. Let me tell you that this index is released by Reporters Sans Border Organization. Good, it is 142. 142 is India's rank and 180 were the total countries that were assessed in this index. Which country was the top ranked? Quickly tell me that. Very good. 142 is India's rank and India's score was 46.56. This was India's score. Score is also important for you to remember when it is about India. When it is the score of India, then it is important for you. Which country? It is Norway, not Iceland. What is India's rank on affordability parameter of Inclusive Internet Index? This is released by Economist Intelligence Unit. Very good. Affordability mein India is the 20th ranked country, which is a very good position for India out of 120 countries. 120 countries were the total number of countries that were assessed in this Inclusive Internet Index. Now guys, which country is at the top? Which country has topped this index? India's overall rank is 49th. Remember, this is the overall rank. And here the 20th rank is on the affordability parameter rank. Okay. Which country has topped this index? Very good, Ankit Pandey. It is Sweden. Sweden has topped this index. Now we have talked about affordability parameter. What are the other parameters? Relevance and readiness. So these are the other four पैरामीटर्स एंड सबसे बेस्ट इंडिया की रैंकिंग इज है अगर किसी पैरामीटर में है तो वो है अफोर्डेबिलिटी पैरामीटर. सो इंडिया हैज स्कोर्ड द बेस्ट इन अफोर्डेबिलिटी पैरामीटर. सो हियर इंटरनेट इज अवेलेबल एट अ वेरी चीप कॉस्ट, देयरफॉर द रैंकिंग इज वेरी गुड एट 20th. व्हाट इज इंडियाज रैंकिंग इन द अदर पैरामीटर्स इन अवेलेबिलिटी? व्हाट इज इंडियाज रैंक? कैन यू गाइस टेल मी द इंडियाज रैंक इन दीज थ्री रिमेनिंग पैरामीटर्स? ओवरऑल रैंकिंग भी इंडिया की बहुत अच्छी है इस इंक्लूसिव इंटरनेट इंडेक्स में. ओके, सो availability met is 77th, relevance met is 49th, and readiness met is 29th. So these are the rankings of India in different parameters, and parameter ranking is also very important, particularly for India. Okay. Moving on to the next question. The new dispute resolution system for small taxpayers will be available to assessees with taxable income up to dash in cases where disputed income is up to dash respectively. So which one is the right answer? So let me tell you, the right answer here is this, option C. 50 lakhs should be the income of the taxpayers and 10 lakhs should be the disputed income. And if both of these parameters are fulfilled by the taxpayers, only then they can avail this new dispute resolution system. Okay, so moving on to the next question. What is the total corpus of Amazon Sambhav Venture Fund? So Amazon conducted its Amazon Sambhav Summit in the month of April, where this online platform announced three big initiatives. First one is this Amazon Venture Fund, Amazon Sambhav Venture Fund. Second one is bringing 1 million small retailers and neighborhood, basically small neighborhood retailers and MSMEs on its platform, on online platform. ठीक है, and the third initiative was Spotlight Northeast. Spotlight is the name of this mission. Okay, mission or the decision that Amazon has taken. So Spotlight Northeast में what will Amazon do? Amazon will bring the artisans or the traders from the northeastern region onto its platform. ठीक है, and all these initiatives will be achieved by 2025. So the year is 2025. Now you have to tell what is the venture fund, what is the corpus of this fund. Good, it is option E, 250 million. And what is the purpose of this fund? Why is this fund created? The purpose is to digitize the small and medium enterprises as well as startups. So digitization is the purpose of this Sambhav Venture Fund. Who heads RBI's committee for evaluating the role of asset reconstruction companies? So which committee, or we can say who heads the committee of RBI that is going to evaluate the role of asset reconstruction companies? Good, option A, Sudarshan Sen is the right answer. Who has been appointed as a chairman and managing director of Small Industries Development Bank of India? That is SIDBI. Who is the CMD of SIDBI? Good, S. Raman is the right answer. Who has been appointed as the new Director General of National Anti-Doping Agency? So here the right answer is option B. Siddharth Singh Longjam is the right answer. What is the theme of the World Heritage Day 2021? So first of all, this day is observed on April 18. World Heritage Day. Theme batao iski for the current year, for 2021. Very good. So this answer is given by Ankit Pandya again. Option D is the right answer. Complex past diverse futures is the right theme. When is World Liver Day observed? Quickly tell me the date. What is the date? World Liver Day. Very good. 19 April is the date. And theme is keep your liver disease free and healthy. Who has won the 2020 Association for Computing Machineries AM Turing Award? So this award is also considered as the Nobel Prize of Computing. So who has won this award? Guys, you need to remember this thing as well, that this AM Turing Award is given in the field of computing. It is considered the Nobel Prize of Computing, because I could have asked you that in which field or which field is this AM Turing Prize recognized. Then you should know the answer, that it is the computing in which this award is given. In the field of computing, this award is given. Okay, so the right answer here is option D. This Alfred V. Aho and this Jeffrey David Ullman both have won this award. Who has won Vaclav Havel Human Rights Prize 2020? Top European Rights Prize. So this is the top prize in the field of human rights given in Europe. So who has won this award? Let me tell you that this award has been won by a Saudi Arabian activist. Now, who is that person? You have to name that person. Good. It is option B. It's Laujan Al-Hathlon, and she has been given this award for her fight for women rights. Now, that is not important for you to know. You can just remember this thing, that she is from Saudi Arabia. She is an activist from Saudi Arabia, and she has been awarded that award. Copa del Rey football tournament is conducted in which country? So Argentina, Spain, France, Italy, Germany are in the options. Let me tell you that this year Barcelona won it. Now I think you have got the answers. Good, Pratik. So the right answer is, I'm waiting for your answers, guys. I don't think that it should take this much time to answer it. Quickly tell me, where was this held? Very good, in Spain. Which country does Eliud Kipchoge belong to? So he is an athlete, and he is a very world famous athlete, I would say. So remember, because he has made many world records in the field of race or in the field of athletics. So which country does he belong to? Kenya, Netherlands, Greek, US or Belgium? Which one is the right answer? So let me tell you, the right answer is option A. He is a Kenyan athlete. Remember that. Who is the author of the Cursed Inheritance book? That is the question for you. Tell me, The Cursed Inheritance is the book of which author? You have Stupa Basu, Vasudev Mohi, Richard Powers, Juhi Karkare, and Rupa Pai in the options. Basu, very good. Stupa Basu is the right answer. Good, Pratik. So, Kenya's capital is Nairobi. Absolutely right. And it is the headquarters of United Nations Environment Programme. So, this is the additional information which Pratik has given us. So, very good. And all of you need to remember this thing, that Nairobi is UNEP's capital. Which country does Stefanos Tsitsipas belong to? He is a tennis player, guys. Remember this thing. Greek, Scotland, Russia, Ukraine, Poland are in the options. So he is the tennis player of which country? What is the nationality of this tennis player? Okay, so the right answer is Greek. So he is from Greece. With which country's Administrative Council for Economic Defense has Competition Commission of India signed an MOU for cooperation? Yes, Monte Carlo Masters 2021 event was won by that person, Stefanos. Brazil, New Papua Guinea, Vanuatu, Fiji, New Caledonia. Which one is the right answer? This Administrative Council for Economic Defense belongs to which country, or is the authority of which country? It is Brazil, guys. This authority is of Brazil, and with this authority, Competition Commission of India has signed an MOU for cooperation. According to Global Energy Review 2021 by International Energy Agency, global carbon dioxide emissions would rise to dash this year. Very good. And you would be amazed to know that this is the increment from 1.5 billion tons last year in 2020. So this is the largest single increase that has been seen in this decade. Matlab 1.5 billion se seedha 33 billion tons is the carbon dioxide emission for this year. This is because this much carbon emission we witnessed last year because of the COVID induced lockdown. So everywhere there was lockdown, so carbon emission reduced in 2020 drastically, and this would be the normal carbon emission that we do, 33 billion tons or somewhere around it. But in 2020 it reduced to 1.5 billion tons precisely because of the COVID lockdowns. Moving on to the next question, what is the total corpus of RBI's Government Securities Acquisition Program 1.0? What is the total corpus of GSAP 1.0? Good. It is 1 trillion. Under this program, RBI is going to acquire the government securities so that the government will get liquidity. GSEP 2.0 has also been launched by RBI. So guys, can you tell me what is the corpus or basically of how much worth of government securities will RBI acquire under this GSEP 2.0 program? So can you tell me that? It is also in trillion. So how much trillion? Okay, so Nilesh has given the answer 35K crores. No Nilesh, it is 1.2 trillion. Or yes, bilkul sahi Prashant, it is 1.2 trillion of securities, worth of government securities that RBI will acquire under its RBI's GSEP 2.0 program. So that is something that you need to know, because this program is all about acquisition. So how much is the worth, or how much amount is being spent under this program is the crux of this program, guys. So that is something you need to know. Asian Development Bank has partnered with Habitat for Humanity International to help microfinance institutions deliver housing loans to low-income families in rural and peri-urban areas of India, Bangladesh, dash and the dash. So which are the other two countries for which Asian Development Bank, that is ADB, and Habitat for Humanity International have partnered? This is, guys, an important question. This can be asked in your NABARD examination. Okay, so yes, it is option D. Indonesia and Philippines are the options. Okay. Who has been appointed as the new chairman of Credit Suisse? What is the answer of this question, guys? Very good. Option B, Horta Osorio, is the right answer. He has been appointed as the chairman of Credit Suisse, and the headquarters of this organization is Zurich, Switzerland. Who is the MD and CEO of DCB Bank? Very good, guys. It is Murali M. Natarajan, who has been appointed as the CEO and MD of the DCB Bank. When is the National Civil Services Day observed? good. It is April 21. That is the right answer. Can you tell me that who referred to the Indian Administrative Services as the steel frame of India? Who called Indian Administrative Services as the steel frame of India? गुड, इट इज वल्लभ भाई पटेल, सरदार वल्लभ भाई पटेल. जी वेंकटा सुभया इज रिलेटेड टू विच फील्ड? रिसेंटली ही पास्ड अवे. That's why this is in the question. Very good. He was a writer. And from which sect of India was he a writer? He was a Kannada writer. Where is the headquarters of Universal Postal Union located? So you have these options. Quickly tell me Universal Postal Union's headquarters. Quickly tell me guys, where is the headquarters of the Universal Postal Union? So let me tell you, it is in Bern, Switzerland. Who among the following is known as the father of banking reforms in India? Now why is he in the news? Because he also passed away in the month of April. This is not something that you need to know. I mean, you need to remember. It is just for your information. So, who was known as the father of banking reforms? Very good. M. Narasimham is the right answer. Which IIT has successfully commercialized COVID app, the novel diagnostic technology? Basically, who developed this COVID app? Which IIT developed this COVID app technology? Very good. It is IIT Kharagpur. How much is the agriculture, infrastructure and development cess on petrol? Agricultural, infrastructure and development cess on petrol. So this is a very, I would say, a very trivial information from which the question has been made. Very good. 2.5 per liter. Diesel pe hai rupees 4 per liter. And guys, this cess was introduced through Finance Bill of 2021. Theek hai? Which state has become the first state in India to have a uniform civil code? This is a very, I would say, important question. Even if it is not asked in your examination at any stage, particularly in NABARD, even then also it is important for you to know that which state is the first in India that has a civil, uniform civil code. That means the one kind of law for all kinds of communities in the state. Good, it is Goa. Pan India also, there were discussions to have a uniform civil code, but they were just discussions till now, because India is such a diverse country with so many communities that it is very hard to implement a uniform civil code. But Goa has fortunately become the first state to have this uniform civil code. So now every community in Goa is governed by this civil code. So that reduces the chances of disputes or disharmony in the state. Okay. Next question is, which state has signed an MOU with the World Trade Center to provide a conducive environment in the state for bringing investment through the new modes and operations? So basically, this is the investment agreement that has been signed with World Trade Center or the MOU for investment. So which state has signed this MOU? Good, it is Haryana. With which IIT has National Cooperative and Development Corporation signed an MOU for collaboration in areas related to the development of cooperatives, agriculture and allied sectors for sustainable development? Which IIT has partnered with NCDC for promotion of these sectors or for promotion of sustainable development in these sectors? Cooperatives, agriculture and allied sectors. Again, this is related to agriculture and allied sectors. Therefore, chances of this question being asked in the examination increases. Now, which IIT is this? Again, it is Kharagpur. Which has become the first country in the world to ratify the Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement, RCEP agreement. So which country is the first in the world to implement this agreement? Ratify means to implement. This is the agreement from which India withdrew. India was out of this RCEP. Singapore, absolutely right. 15 countries are members of this agreement, including 10 Asian members. Theek hai? Apart from the Asian members, which are the countries? China, South Korea, Australia, New Zealand and Japan, you can see on your screens. So these are the other five countries. Guys, my question from you is the name of the countries that are part of ASEAN, because all the ASEAN members are part of this 15-member grouping of RCEP or Regional Comprehensive Economic Partnership. So you need to tell me that what are the names of the countries that are the part of this RCEP agreement apart from these five countries: China, South Korea, Australia, New Zealand, Japan. So out of the 15 members, I have told you the names of the five members. You need to tell me the remaining 10 members' name. Quickly tell me, within no time, just tell me that what are the names of the countries that are members of ASEAN? This is solving two purposes, guys. First is this related to RCAP and second is the static question, because you need to know the names of the countries that are members of ASEAN. This is the part of your static general awareness. I think you don't know the names of the countries. Guys, if you don't know the names of Asian, then I'm very disappointed at you guys, because your examination is just around the corner and you don't know the names of Asian members. It is your regional organization which is very important for your examination, and you still don't know. What would you have done if this question is in your examination, if this would be your NABARD grade A phase 1 examination, and I would have asked you which of the following is not a member of ASEAN? Okay, so Rajat, you have missed Cambodia. Cambodia is also a member. So you have mentioned only 9 member countries. 10 are you in Cambodia is also a part of this Asian grouping. Moving ahead, so I think people are googling the answer. They are finding the member countries of Asian on Google. Therefore, it is taking a lot of time to you to answer this question. And that is precisely my question, Rajat. Why don't you guys remember the countries, the names of the countries of ASEAN or the SAARC or any other regional organization? Because this is a static portion. If you are an aspirant, if you are a serious aspirant, then you should know the answer of such questions, because these are very basic questions. Okay, so at this point, I'm really disappointed at all of you guys. Okay, so moving on to the next question. What is the name of the instruments used by NASA to generate oxygen on Mars? Okay, so I also want to say this thing. Don't ignore your static GK. Although you have a major chunk coming from the current affairs in your examination, but that does not mean you can skip static GK. Because static GK is first of all easier to remember than current affairs, and secondly, static GK also constitute your 10 to 15% of questions. Okay, so don't ignore it. Okay, MOXIE is the name of the instrument used by NASA to generate oxygen on another planet. Moving on to the next question, which of the following country has been recommended as the countries of particular concern by US Commission on International Religious Freedom? So this organization basically releases a report in which it mentions countries of particular concern or other countries which need monitoring, particularly if they have religious disharmony in the country. So which country has been recommended as the countries of particular concern? That you have to tell. Yes, all of the above is the right answer, and India is also a part of this. And this report mentions that there is an increasing intolerance in Indian population against the Muslim population. So that was the highlight of this report from our point of view. What is the 2021 global average score in the World Economic Forum's Global Energy Transition Index 2021? Global average score. So global average score and India's scores are important. Okay, good Rajat, it is 59. India, global average score is 59. How many total countries were assessed in this index? Can you tell me for total number of countries that were assessed in this index? total number of countries that were assessed in this index was 115. Out of these 115 countries, India ranked 87th at the 87th position with a score of 52. Sweden is at the top position. Okay. Okay, so this question we have already discussed. That India's ranking is option A, 87th. So I'm moving on to the next question. Which has become the first cryptocurrency exchange in India? First cryptocurrency exchange. So that you have to tell. Let me tell you that the company which has become the first cryptocurrency exchange in India is a UAE based company. Bifinance, Bitfinex, Bitex, Bitmain, Bitpay. Which one is the right answer? Okay, so here the right answer is Bitex. Recently, Google and Amazon Web Services have launched Nimbus project to provide cloud-based data, regional data services to Dash government. So Nimbus project is for which country? Israel, Japan, China, Philippines, Singapore, out of which Israel is the right answer. When is the World Creativity and Innovation Day observed? Good. April 21 is the right answer. So 2021 is the UN International Year of Creative Economy for Sustainable Development. So that is also another information that you need to remember. UN International Year of Creative Economy for Sustainable Development. Guys, you need to answer me that a special prize was created by UN. Okay, in the field of creative economy, can you tell me that the prize is honored or is in the honor of which personality? UN Creative Economy Award. So it is basically named after a great personality. So which personality is this? That you have to tell me. किस पर्सनालिटी के नाम पे यूनाइटेड नेशंस ने ये न्यू अवार्ड क्रिएट किया था इन ऑर्डर टू ऑनर दैट पर्सनालिटी. ओके, सो अ हिंट फॉर यू इज दैट इट इज ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ 100th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ दैट पर्सनालिटी ऑफ दैट पर्सन. वेरी गुड. सो सुहास सूर्यवंशी, एब्सोल्यूटली राइट. सो इट इज बंगाबंधु शेख मुजीबुर रहमान ऑन हुज 100th anniversary, that is in 2021 only, this UN Creative Economy Award was created by United Nations in order to honor that person. Okay, good. This we have already discussed. That is 2021 is the UN International Year of Creative Economy for Sustainable Development. Moving on to the next question. When is the World Homeopathy Day observed? Good, April 10. Okay, so a very basic question from you is, who is known as the father of homeopathy? Tell me that quickly. Because his birth anniversary is observed as World Homeopathy Day. So tell me that who is the father of homeopathy? April 10 is the birth anniversary of this person. जर्मनी को बिलोंग करते थे. ही वॉज अ जर्मन फिजिस्ट. अजमाल खान नहीं. नो, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द वर्ल्ड, द फादर ऑफ होम्योपैथी. Very good. So, Methali, it is absolutely right. It is Samuel Hahnemann who is the right answer, who is known as the father of homeopathy. And on his birth anniversary only, we observe the World Homeopathy Day. Which country has won the ICC 100% cricket female cricket initiative of the year? So, this is basically an accolade or an award, you can say. ठीक है, so who has won this award? 100% cricket female cricket initiative of the year. Good, it is Brazil. So, Cricket Association of Brazil has won this award from ICC. And the one that I am seeing in the options, Tiwari, Mr. Tiwari, Argentine, won the ICC Development Initiative of the Year. Cricket Development Initiative of the Year Award. Okay, so again we have another question from Global Energy Transition Index. So we have discussed it thoroughly above itself. So I'm skipping this question. वैसे बता देती हूँ, total number of countries that were assessed was 115. We have already discussed it above. Which state is mentioned as the best state for its public health service during the pandemic as per the Beyond the Pandemic Building Back Better from Crisis in Asia and the Pacific Report? Which state is the best state? This is a very common question. Vijay Ramnath, very good question. So let me tell you that banking current affairs are very important. ठीक है, but it depends upon the examination you are focusing upon. For example, if you are focusing upon SEBI, then banking and finance current affairs are very important. I would say majority of the questions are SEBI focuses on are from the banking and finance current affairs. If you are talking about RBI, then RBI has 80 questions out of 200 questions. So RBI does not stick to banking and finance. It asks questions from every field, whichever is possible, whichever is the field that RBI sees that I can take question from. So it takes questions from that field, be it sports, cricket, everything. If you are talking about NABARD grade A examination, that is the session, that is the examination that is upcoming and for which we have taken this session. So if you are talking about NABARD, then current affairs related to agriculture, rural development are said to be more important. But as I have seen from my past experience of the examinations, NABARD also asks questions from awards, sports, books, banking. So every session, every section is important. As far as your question is important, that how much focus you should lay on banking and finance news. So I would say in comparison to other sections like national news, wherein you have your government schemes, agriculture sector, you can lay a little bit less focus on banking and finance for your NABARD grade A phase one examination. Okay, because here the focus is more on the other sections of news. For example, government schemes ho gaye, आपका एग्रीकल्चर एंड रूरल डेवलपमेंट, स्पोर्ट्स, अवार्ड्स, एवरीथिंग इज देयर. बट आई एम नॉट एट ऑल सेइंग दैट यू कैन इग्नोर और यू कैन पे, यू कैन जस्ट अवॉइड द बैंकिंग एंड फाइनेंस सेक्शन. आई एम जस्ट सेइंग यू कैन ले अ लिटिल बिट लेस एम्फेसिस ऑन बैंकिंग एंड फाइनेंस सेक्शन, बट नॉट एट ऑल इग्नोर इट. ओके, सो दैट इज समथिंग दैट इज माय एडवाइस. ओके, सो विजय, आई थिंक आई हैव आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन. Okay, coming back to this question, Kerala is the right answer. With which bank has Google Pay partnered for launching Fi, a new bank for salaried millennials? Now, for example, look at this question, Vijay. So this question is from your banking and finance section, but there is a chance that this question can be asked in your NABARD examination also. So here, does that mean you can ignore this question? Not at all. You have to prepare this question. So that is what I meant to say. You cannot ignore the section or you cannot just leave some news out of that section. You have to cover banking and finance. So I think there is no straightforward answer to this, that you can just ignore or you can just lay less focus on banking and finance. Okay, absolutely right, Tiwari. It's Federal Bank. Where is this Mormugao port located? Where is the port located? Goa, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and Kerala are in the options. Quickly tell me where this port is located. Goa, absolutely right. Goa is the right answer. Which is the first Indian state to have, Indian city, to have a cycling policy? Good, it is Chandigarh. Maharashtra is the state, yaar. We are talking about the city. Which city is the first to have a cycling policy? It's Chandigarh. Acha. Cycles for Change Challenge, Cycles for Change Initiative. First of all, tell me which organization is partnering with the Smart Cities Mission for this initiative, for implementing this initiative. Quickly tell me the name of the organization. Let me tell you, it is a US-based organization. Now tell me that what is the name of the organization? Cycles for Change. This organization is also common in Transport for All initiative. Both of these initiatives are implemented by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Quickly tell me which organization is the partner or is the knowledge partner of Smart Cities Mission for this Cycles for Change initiative and this Transport for All initiative. US based organization hai, kuch hi din pehle padhaya hai, quickly batao jaldi. I had told you that you can take these revision sessions as your NABARD grade A final examination also. Suppose कर लो यही आपका phase one चल रहा है NABARD का. No, not at all. It's not Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and Manvendra. Vijay is not correct. Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation is not the ubiquitous foundation that can partner with any ministry or any organization of India for every kind of mission. No. Although Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation is very favorite of Atal Innovation Mission, but not here. It's not the answer. So I'm going to wait for just 5 seconds for your answers. If you don't answer it, then I will answer it. There is no other option left for us. So quickly, I hope that you can answer the question correctly, because otherwise I would have been disappointed again. And this time a little bit more, because kuch hi din pehle padha hai yaar. And if this question would have come in your NABARD grade A phase 1 GA examination, then what would you have done? Chalo, main hi bata deti hu. That means you don't know the answer. It is Institute. For development. And this is a US based organization, Institute for Development and Transportation. This is basically a US-based organization and the Indian arm of this organization. It's the Institute for Transportation and Development Policy. So I have written it a bit wrong. Institute for Transportation and Development Policy. Transportation and Development Policy. Okay, so this is the right name. This is located in US and the Indian branch of this organization is partnering with Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs for this Cycles for Change initiative and Transportation initiative. And recently top 11 cities have been given the honor of top 11 cycling pioneers of India. Basically those top 11 cities have won this challenge. Okay, so I hope now you can remember the institution and the facts associated with those initiatives. Moving on to the next question. What is the target of mustard cultivation set up by the Ministry of Agriculture and Family Welfare for 2025 to 2026? I hope that you can answer this question correctly. Good, 17 million tons. At present it is 9 million tons. So it is to be increased to this much. This is important. Mustard cultivation ka target hai ye central government ka. That's why it is important. Moving on to the next question. Where will the 6th forum on TB vaccine be held? Global forum on TB vaccine. The right answer is option B. It's in the France that the 6th Global Forum on TB vaccine will be held. The 5th edition of this forum was held virtually this year. Therefore, this forum will be held in person. Who among the following will be representing India at the World Cities Culture Forum 2021? Who is going to represent India at World Cities Culture Forum? Quickly tell me. Very good, Arvind Kejriwal, Delhi CM. Future of culture is the theme, UK is the host. UK mein hoga ye forum. Which of the following mission has been sent by NASA to study the interstellar particles in the heliosphere? हीलियोस्फीयर में इंटरस्टेलर पार्टिकल्स को स्टडी करने के लिए विच मिशन वॉज सेंट बाय नासा? गुड, इट इज शील्ड्स. शील्ड्स मिशन वॉज सेंट. Which university has topped in the Times Higher Education Impact Ranking 2021? Quickly tell me the answer of this question. University of Manchester, UK is the right answer. और India से कौन सी है? अमृत विश्व University. Now remember this thing that this impact ranking is the first ranking, first of its kind ranking in the world, which ranks the impact of universities on sustainable development goals. How the universities are contributing towards achieving the sustainable development goals is something assessed in this. The higher education's impact rankings. Which company has executed world's first blockchain enabled paperless trade transaction in the steel industry? So this was undertaken by HSBC Bank for which company from these options? So let me tell you, the right answer is Tata Steel. Who has been chosen as the external auditor of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons from India? So this is basically Organization for Prohibition of Chemical Weapons is the organization, and who has been chosen as the external auditor from India? The question is asking you that. Very good, option B. G.C. Murmu, who is the CAG of India, Comptroller and Auditor General. Who has been appointed as the chairperson of NASSCOM for 2021 to 2022? Quickly tell me, chairperson of NASSCOM. NASSCOM is a very important organization, guys, for India. द राइट आंसर इज रेखा एम मेनन. When is the International Day of Girls in ICT or International Girls in ICT Day observed? Good. 22 अप्रैल. कैन यू टेल मी द थीम एज वेल? व्हाट इज द थीम ऑफ दिस डे, इंटरनेशनल गर्ल्स इन आईसीटी? Connected Girls Creating Brighter Future is the theme for this day in 2021 that you need to remember. Who has become the first Indian woman to scale Mount Annapurna, the 10th highest mountain peak in the world? First Indian woman to scale this Mount Annapurna. राखी शेखर, अनीता वर्मा, पारुल भगेल, प्रियंका मोहिते, चंचल शर्मा आर इन द ऑप्शंस. वेरी गुड. प्रियंका मोहिते इज द राइट आंसर. रजत, गुड. दिस माउंटेन इज लोकेटेड इन नेपाल. विच स्टेट हैज लॉन्च्ड हरिहर पॉलिसी फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग एम्प्लॉयमेंट, एजुकेशनल एंड फाइनेंशियल बेनिफिट्स टू अबैंडन्ड एंड सरेंडर्ड चिल्ड्रन? हरिहर पॉलिसी. हरियाणा, छत्तीसगढ़, झारखंड, वेस्ट बंगाल, त्रिपुरा. इफ यू सी इन द नेम इटसेल्फ, हरिहर, सो देर आर टू टाइम्स वेयर द हर इज देर. हरियाणा इज द राइट आंसर. सो फ्रॉम हियर यू कैन रिमेंबर इट इज हरियाणा दैट हैज लॉन्च्ड दिस स्कीम. What is the total food grain production estimate for 2021 as per the second advanced estimate of production of principal crops by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare? So you have different amounts. You need to tell the total food grain production. Very good. 303.34 million tons. Where did Indian Army conducted ARMEX exercise? So Army, Military Expedition is the full form of this ARMEX. Ladakh, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh. Where is this ARMEX exercise took place? It is option D, Ladakh and Uttarakhand. Which city is the UNESCO's World Book Capital for 2021? Quickly tell me World Book Capital for 2021. Let me tell you that city is in Georgia. Very good. Option D is the right answer. this city is in Georgia, and this is the World Book Capital for 2021. Which bank has collaborated with Google Pay and Visa to enable secured tokenization on its credit cards? Bank of Baroda, HSBC India, Bank of Maharashtra, Canara Bank, Bank of India. Out of which HSBC India is the right answer. Who has been appointed as a part-time chairman of HDFC Bank? Part-time chairmen are not very important until or unless there is no new chairman appointed. So, HDFC Bank does not have any new chairman. So, the part-time chairman is important because he is the at present chairman. So, who is this person? Very good. Atanu Chakraborty is the right answer. Who has won the Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award 2021? Nelson Mandela World Humanitarian Award. Good. Rumana Singh Sehgal is the right answer. Which bank has signed an MOU with the Chennai Angels, Angel Investment Group, to finance startups? So again, this is a good question that can be asked in your examination. So which bank has partnered with this Chennai Angels? Indian Bank, not Indian Overseas Bank. Indian Bank has partnered. With which company has MasterCard partnered to launch Corn QR? A MasterCard QR on card solution. This Corn QR is basically a payment solution for card holders. So which company has launched this Corn QR with MasterCard? Very good. BOB Financial Limited. BOB Financial Solutions Limited. Which state has signed an MOU with Microsoft for imparting digital skills to 1.62 lakh students and unemployed youth across 300 plus colleges and skill development centers in the state? So tell me that these kinds of questions are asked in the examination. We often see these questions as unimportant, but they are not at all unimportant. They have been asked in the examination. So tell me that which state is this? Maharashtra, Gujarat, West Bengal, Andhra Pradesh, and Tamil Nadu are in the options. Andhra Pradesh, absolutely right. Which state's Urja Vikas Nigam has signed a first of its kind power purchase agreement with Coal India? This is not at all important for your examination, so we can just skip this question. Singapore Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry and Startup Incubation and Innovation Center have partnered to provide opportunities to tech-based startups for circular economy and an entrepreneurial ecosystem. Both organizations have launched SICI, SIIC, Innovation Launchpad Challenge for Startups. Startup Incubation and Innovation Center is located at which IIT? So this is the question, guys, that has been asked from you. वेरी गुड. आईआईटी कानपुर में दिस स्टार्टअप इंक्यूबेशन एंड इनोवेशन सेंटर इज लोकेटेड. Which IIT has Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs signed an MOU to set up an accelerator center for research and development at the institute? कौन सी institute है भाई बता दो. Indian Institute कौन सी है जिस पे ये accelerator center for research and development will be set up? IIT धारवाड़, गोवा, जम्मू, खड़गपुर, धनबाद, ये ऑप्शंस में है. विच वन इज द राइट आंसर? वेरी गुड, इट इज ऑप्शन डी, खड़गपुर. विच हैज बिकम द सेकेंड अफ्रीकन कंट्री टू एलिमिनेट ट्रेकोमा? This disease is related to eyes. It causes blindness. ठीक है, this is something you need to know. Ghana, Kenya, Tanzania, Gambia, Morocco. Which one is the right answer, guys? Very good. Gambia is the second country. Ghana is the first African country to eliminate trachoma, which is a disease related to eyesight. When is International Day of Multilateralism and Diplomacy observed? Diplomacy for peace observed. April 24, 5, 29, 13, 11 are in the options. Which is the exact date of this International Day of Multilateralism and Diplomacy for Peace? Yes, April 24 is the right answer. Who has won the League Cup 2021? English Football League tournament. League Cup is related to football. It is an English football tournament. These are the two questions that can be framed out of this League Cup only. So you have to remember that it is an English football tournament. Now tell that which of the following football clubs has won this League Cup 2021? Good, Akhil Sridharan. It is Manchester City that has won this tournament. Where will the ITTF World Tennis Table Tennis Championship be held? The place where this World Table Tennis Championship will be held is going to host this World Table Tennis Championship for the first time in its history. So which country? Absolutely right, it's USA. So Houston is the exact place and US is the country. Where are Maui dolphins found? Basically, a new policy for their conservation has been launched by that country where these Maui dolphins are found. So, where are these found? Philippines, Singapore, Myanmar, Australia, and New Zealand are in the options. Which one is the right answer? Good, New Zealand is the right answer. Who is the author of Living Mountain book? लिविंग माउंटेन, अमिताभ घोष, हरी कुंजरू, अशोक के बनकर, देवदत्त पटनायक, अश्विन सांघी. विच वन इज द राइट आंसर? हु रोट दिस लिविंग माउंटेन बुक? इफ यू गाइज नो द आंसर, आई डोंट थिंक दैट यू नीड दिस मच अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट गिवन दिस मच टाइम इन योर एग्जामिनेशन ऑल्सो. सो क्विकली टेल मी दैट विच वन इज द राइट आंसर. वेरी गुड, इट इज अमिताभ घोष. इफ यू नो द आंसर देन जस्ट क्विकली राइट द आंसर्स. ऑप्शंस भी लिखोगे तो भी चलेगा. वेयर हैज इंडियाज फर्स्ट फ्लोटिंग स्टोरेज एंड रीगैसिफिकेशन यूनिट ऑफ LNG अराइव्ड फ्रॉम सिंगापुर? सो इट इज इंडियाज फर्स्ट स्टोरेज, फ्लोटिंग स्टोरेज एंड रीगैसिफिकेशन यूनिट ऑफ LNG. वेरी गुड, इट इज महाराष्ट्र. ऑप्शन ई इज द राइट आंसर. गाइज रिमेंबर दैट इट इज द इंडियाज फर्स्ट एवर, फर्स्ट ऑफ इट्स काइंड फ्लोटिंग स्टोरेज एंड रीगैसिफिकेशन यूनिट फॉर LNG दैट हैज अराइव्ड एट महाराष्ट्र. विद विच कंपनी हैज इंडियन आर्मी पार्टनर्ड फॉर लद्दाख इग्नाइटेड माइंड्स, अ सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस एंड वेलनेस प्रोजेक्ट टू प्रोवाइड बेटर एजुकेशनल अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर लद्दाखी स्टूडेंट्स? लद्दाख इग्नाइटेड माइंड्स. ओके, सो अखिल श्रीधरन एब्सोल्युटली राइट, इट इज हिंदुस्तान पेट्रोलियम कॉर्पोरेशन लिमिटेड, HPCL. हाउ मच फंड विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द यूथ टू रिकवर फ्रॉम द COVID-19 पेंडेमिक अंडर द UN ग्लोबल यूथ मोबिलाइजेशन लोकल सॉल्यूशंस कैंपेन? कितना फंड प्रोवाइड किया जाएगा यूथ को सो दैट दे कैन रिकवर फ्रॉम द COVID-19 पेंडेमिक? रिकवरी इन द सेंस, इन द सेंस ऑफ एम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड स्किल्स, ओके, विच मेक देम मोर एम्प्लॉयबल. यस, $2 million. सुरोंग इज द फर्स्ट मार्स रोवर ऑफ विच कंट्री? It is China. Zhurong is the China's first rover that has been developed to be launched on Mars. Which country has partnered with Microsoft to build the world's most powerful supercomputer to forecast weather and climate change? Good, it is UK. UK and Microsoft are going to develop this supercomputer which can forecast weather and climate change. According to Stockholm International Peace Research Institute's Trends in World Military Expenditure 2020 report, India accounts for -% of world's military expenditure. So if you take the entire pie of the military expenditure of the world, then what is the share of India in that pie? You are wrong, Johan. The right answer is 3.7%. The share is 3.7%. What is the prescribed tenure for MD and CEO of banks as per the new guidelines of RBI? Tell me the answer. Years is the right answer. Who has been appointed as the new MD and CEO of National Commodity and Derivatives Exchange of India? Quickly tell me. Raj, this is the general guideline for all the banks. The minimum limit for MDs and CEO. The limit for MDs and CEO for holding the office. Age limit. If you know the answer, then tell me so that I can move ahead. Very good. It is Arun Raste who has been appointed as the MD and CEO of this National Commodity Exchange. How many countries were supported by the E2020 campaign of WHO for elimination of malaria? So you need to know that this E2020 campaign is related to malaria. Now, how many countries were supported by this E2020? Here the right answer is 21. A total number of 21 countries were supported. So this E2020 campaign was launched in 27 in order to eliminate malaria by the year 2020. And 21 countries were in focus. So in 21 countries, the purpose was to eliminate malaria. Which picture has received the Best Picture Award at the Oscars 2021? Which picture is this? It is Nomadland. Can you guys tell me who is the director of this picture? Name of the director of Nomadland. This director also won the Best Director Award at Oscars. Nomadland, so I know who is the director of Nomadland. That is, I'm asking you. Yes, yes, absolutely right. So Rajat, you have given the full name. It's Chol Zhao. She is the director of this Nomadland and she also got the Best Director Award. On which aircraft has the 5th generation Python 5 air-to-air missile been equipped? Which aircraft is this Python 5 air-to-air missile been equipped? Raj, the other questions that I'm asking you, I am not supposed to give you the options for those questions because they are your memory based question. I'm testing your memory here. So why should I give you the options? You need to know such information at the fingertips. Yes, she is Chinese. Chol Zhao was a Chinese and she was the first woman, Asian woman, to win the best director. Yes, Tejas is the right answer. With which country has India signed an MOU for customs cooperation and mutual administrative assistance in customs matters? UK is the right answer, absolutely right. Blue Nature Alliance aims to conserve at least -% of the world's ocean by 2030. This is important, guys. Tell me that how much ocean is going to be conserved by this Blue Nature Alliance. This quiz is not at all rigged because there is no prize on this quiz. If you win the quiz, there is no prize for you. Okay, so this is not at all rigged. I find this really funny. The people who are answering the answers, who are giving the answers before flashing of the questions, that is first of all not possible. I'm just flashing the question and after that only they are giving the answers. The second thing is they must have prepared Spotlight thoroughly and they already have given the answers. They already have practiced the questions in the Spotlight of April. Therefore, they are giving the questions, the answers so fast. Okay. Neo 1 is the robot prototype for cleaning the orbit of the debris left behind by other spacecraft. Which country does the prototype belong to, or which country developed this Neo 01 prototype? Germany, France, China, Russia, Finland are in the options. Which one is the right answer? Okay, so China is the right answer. And remember, Origin Space is a company that has developed this. What is India's rank in the Chandler Good Government Index 2021? Total 104 countries were assessed in this index. Good government index. Kitni good hai hamari government. This is something that this index tells us. So tell me, what is India's rank? Very good, 49th. And Finland is the top country. So the best government in the world is in Finland. And India's government is the 49th best government. This is also a very good ranking out of 104 countries. Which company has launched India's first wealth community based on video? Basically, payment, wealth community payment solution based on video. India has improved its ranking in comparison to the previous year's ranking. Paytm, absolutely right. Guys, this is the GDP question and I have already told you that I am going to take a session on GDP wherein we will be discussing the latest GDPs because Asian Development Bank has also released its new GDP forecast. Therefore, I'm just skipping that question, but you don't have to worry about the GDP forecast because I'm going to take a session on that as well. वेयर इज द खेलो इंडिया स्टेट सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस फॉर रोइंग लोकेटेड? सो गाइज वी आर ऑन 103rd question एंड वी हैव 125 क्वेश्चन. सो देर इज अ वेरी लेस अमाउंट ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट आर रिमेनिंग, सो यू हैव टू बेयर विद इट. जस्ट बी अ लिटल पेशेंट, 15-20 मिनट्स मोर एंड दिस सेशन विल बी ओवर. ओके, गुड. इट इज इन श्रीनगर. ऑप्शन ई इज द राइट आंसर. दिस इंडियाज फर्स्ट वेल्थ कम्युनिटी बेस्ड ऑन वीडियो, दिस इज बेसिकली अ कम्युनिटी, अ टाइप ऑफ ग्रुपिंग दैट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड बाय पेटीएम फॉर फैसिलिटेटिंग पेमेंट्स. ठीक है, सो लाइक वी क्रिएट कम्युनिटी, लाइक वी क्रिएट व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप, सो दिस इज द कम्युनिटी क्रिएटेड बाय पेटीएम बेस्ड ऑन वीडियो. दैट इज द पर्पज. Now you don't have to go into the mechanics of this, how is this created and how is it going to work, because for phase one this much information is relevant and sufficient. Moving on to the next question. Recently Prime Minister Narendra Modi condoled the demise of the Dadudan Gadvi. Which field did he belong to? Tekken games I do that, okay, whenever I feel that is important then I do that, but the questions which are not of very much importance I don't give other facts about those questions, and this is a revision session, remember that. This is not the class wherein you are discussing the facts about the news, you are discussing news in detail, because we are taking 125 questions and this has taken 2 hours in just discussing the answers only. Then what would have happened if we discuss the details as well? It will stretch for 5 hours and we cannot sit for 5 hours. Okay, so he belongs to literature, he is a poet and he is a Gujarati poet. Okay, so remember this thing. Non-deposit taking NBFCs with asset size below dash have the option to not follow the guidelines for appointment of statutory, central auditors, statutory auditors of commercial banks excluding RRBs, UCBs and NCBs including HFCs. So this whole guideline was released by RBI and I recommend you guys that you need to cover these guidelines very thoroughly, because they can be asked in your NABARD examination as well. Good, 500 crore is the right answer. Which IIT has created India's first 3D printed house? Obituary is important, Raj. They can be asked. And I remember there was a question on Terry Chief, the chief of Terry who passed away. And which field did he belong to was a question in your RBI examination, I guess, in 2019 or something. So obituaries are important. They are being asked in the examination and you don't have to remember much about them. You just need to remember the person's nationality, if he is a foreigner, and the field which he belonged to. That is the thing that you need to remember. IIT Madras is the right answer, absolutely right. How much is India's target for the Indian chemical industry by 2025? what is the target of Indian chemical industry? $145 billion is the right answer. Which edition of Varun exercise was conducted by India and France in 2021? Which edition of this Varun exercise was conducted between India and France in 2021? That you have to tell me. So let me tell you, it was the 19th edition that took place in the Arabian Sea, Western Arabian Sea. Which country does Tiahe space station module belong to? So it belongs to China. Can you? Tiangong. Okay, so this is the space station that is being developed by China. What is the corpus of MasterCard Impact Fund launched by the MasterCard to address the COVID-19 crisis in India? What is the corpus of this fund? MasterCard Impact Fund. The right answer here is option B, US 10 million. Yes, Indira ka 12th edition was recently conducted. Who has been designated as the finance secretary or secretary in the Ministry of Finance? Quickly tell me the answer of this question, guys. Secretary in the Ministry of Finance. Twelfth edition of Indira exercise between India and Russia. Volgograd was the place where this took place. This is a city in Russia. Remember that. Now the right answer for this is TV Somanathan. When is the World Day for Safety and Health at Work observed? If you know that out of the four labor codes, we have one code on occupational safety, health and workplace conditions. Okay, so this is another information that you need to know. When is this day observed? Safety and health. Good, April 28 is the right answer. Who has been chosen as the first Indian and Asian woman for the 2021 Wild Innovator Award? First Indian and Asian woman, Wild Innovator Award. Quickly tell me. So out of these options, option C, Kriti K. Karant is the right answer. Which of the following Indian company has entered the Times 100 Most Influential Companies 2021 list? The right answer to this question is option E. Byju's and Jio are the two companies that have entered this list. Which field is Manoj Das related to? Was he a badminton player, author, singer, sitarist, or environmental conservationist? Who was he? Manoj Das was an author. Border Roads Organization is celebrating the 60th anniversary of Project Dantak, which was launched in 1961 to develop roads and connectivity in which country? So the right answer is Bhutan. Project Dantak was launched in Bhutan to develop the roads and connectivity in Bhutan. Mukti Jodha Scholarship Scheme aims to provide scholarships to the students of which country? So this scholarship scheme has been launched by India to provide scholarship to the students of Bangladesh. Which state has launched the Ashirwad Scheme? Prashant, it is on the website. anujindal.in, currentaffairs.anujindal.in. That is the website from where you can download the spotlight. Punjab. Good. The right answer is option E, Punjab. Which year will be celebrated as Asian India Friendship Year? This question is important. Asian India Friendship Year. Which one is the right answer? It is 2022. How many countries are a part of the Net Zero Producers Forum? 5, 7, 10, 20, 50. The right answer is 5. Where did North Atlantic Treaty Organization conduct the joint military exercise named Defender Europe 2021? Bulgaria, Albania, Cyprus, Lithuania, Monaco. Where did this Defender Europe 2021 exercise took place? Prashant, PDF is available for free, so you can download it on the website. Yes, Saudi Arabia recently joined. Very good. Yes, available for all. Albania is the right answer. Which country has the largest number of hydrogen car distribution in the world as per the Global EV Outlook 2021 of International Energy Agency? So the right answer is Korea. Korea has the highest number of hydrogen cars plying on its roads. Next, which of the following promoter has been reclassified as the public shareholder in Axis Bank? So which company is this? not a very prominent question from your exam point of view, but still we need to know such news as well. United India Insurance Company, Oriental Insurance Company, National Insurance Company, General Insurance Company, or New India Assurance Company, out of which option E, New India Assurance Company Limited, is the right answer. Which bank has launched Merchant Stack, a digital bank banking service for retail merchants? This is again important. ICICI Bank has launched this Merchant Stack. Who has won the Order of the Rising Sun Gold and Silver Race? First of all, this Order of the Rising Sun Gold and Silver Race is the award of which country? Which country gives this award? Good. Option B, Shyamala Ganesh. And this award is given by Japan. So this is the third highest honor given by the Japanese government. And here this session ends. So this elongated session of 2 hours 15 minutes has finally ended. If you have any queries, you can ask me or I will end this session. But before ending this session, let me tell you that PDFs are available on the website currentaffairs.anujindal.in, where you can just download the PDF. Yes, from Shyamala Ganesh is from Bangalore and she has been given this award to promote Japanese culture in India. Yes, absolutely right. So I guess you don't have any queries. Therefore, I'm ending the session. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you.